Welcome everybody to Let's Play Amnesia. I'm your host, that guy, and just let me set my timer. Here we go. Okay, and we're off. From what I remember, we just came out of a elevator which just plummeted right to the bottom, which, for no lack of better words, we should have died in. So, only got a few cuts and bruises, and we have a slight headache. So, in perspective, it seems alright. Kinda stuck here. What? What is he getting freaked out by? There's like nothing there. Jerks. You have to excuse me, I actually have a bit of been having some almonds today, and I got a bit stuck in my throat. Not that it really stuck in my throat per se, but they are stuck in my teeth, actually. Would be a more accurate description of it. Why is that scary? Come on! Oh, okay, I see why it's scary. God damn it. Okay, so I can hide in there at least. The very least. Okay, we got a bit of night vision. That's good. That's good. Can't see a single thing in this way. It appears that the enemy is light up like a Christmas tree when you find them, though, so it's not really that bad per se. Of course, as long as the enemies don't follow me in here, I'm pretty much safe. At the same time, we don't really know where the enemies are, so we're just gonna crawl along. Hope that we don't run into anyone. Can hear him though. It does take him a few hits to actually kill us though, so it's not really that bad as you think. Hammer. Ugh. God damn it. Just be 1 second, everyone. Sorry about that. That's a phone call there for me. So. It actually looks like movement in there, but at the same time. That sounds very bloody dangerous. Let's not go there, huh? Crap. I got goosebumps. Man. Oh, God. Really do need to... Ugh. Come on, phone. Go back to timing mode. There we go. There we go. We're going to sneak. Sneaking. The way that we are meant to travel. In style. Crap! There's one of them there. Stop doing that fucking thing with my damn eyesight. I get it. I can't stare at him. No. Oh god, my brain is deteriorating apparently. At least he gave a kind of moan before showing. Oh man, I'm gonna hate this, aren't I? So eerie in here. Can't see damping either. Ah, thank you. Oh god. Stop with the creepiness. Let me get some backs on my own sanity. I'm not gonna run in case they can actually hear my footsteps, which I gotta admit seems like a logical thing in this game. Crap! It's one of them. Oh man. He can't even walk properly. He is just like in a daze, basically. He is that freaked out, he can't even walk straight. Please don't tell me I gotta play like this. Man. I really don't want to play this game like an idiot and just be like stuck without Oh.
Please, we don't have time to make the hole any wider. Someone is coming. Hurry. I'll cover the hole with the bed. Everything will be fine. I promise.
Okay. Can't get in there. Fine. Fine, 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 fine! Ugh. Has there ever been a game that you really wanted to finish, just to get it over and done with? Yes. It's called Amnesia. Why? Isn't it a good game? It is a good game. I love the game. It just scares the living daylights out of me, that's all. I see. Do you think that's a good reason to not want to play a game? I don't know, to me it sounds a pretty good idea. Corroded and weak, so maybe we can smash the lock somehow. Oh! Chipper! Okay.
Where did she go?
No! Oh, tell! I'll never tell you!
You're just making things worse.
Look, is that our voice?
This is no place for a young girl all by herself.
That's our voice.
She could be hurt or worse. There's no telling what horrors await down there.
Why are we... Okay. Maybe we can use them two together. Oh! Okay. It said it was a weak lock. Maybe we can, The enemy lit up like a Christmas tree. That it. Can we? Yeah! Alright. Weak lock. Ooh. I'm not gonna mess around with the dead. That's just a bit wrong. Everything must be moved, Sayo. Everything. You name it, we will move it. Oh man. That is not a good sign at all. Thank you for taking out all the light though. I can hear it. Can't do a damn thing about it, but I can hear it. Oh god. Please don't come near here. How could we be so freaked out yet only have a slight headache? That's a little wrong. I'm not going to use the health yet, just only because just in case it actually improves our status a little bit too much, I guess you could say. They don't even give us a candle in here. Don't know where he's gone, don't really care. Yes! That's automatic. That wasn't me actually banging into it or something. Crystal clear. I don't think you can actually have a crystal clear mindset when you're freaked out like all hell. So, servants avoided him, yet he knew they were there. They all smelled of spiced wine, a mystic scent permeated by clove and sage. Oh, also guys, I actually got a haircut now. So I don't look so much like a L anymore, which is actually my little avatar picture that I've got there. I know he's got green hair and that, but I actually kind of like him with green hair. It looks kind of better, actually. I mean, typically, I don't know which way to go. Oh. Obviously, we're in a cave, so you might want to have light on. Just so our character doesn't get freaked out. These rocks can move. Eh. Eh. Come on. Come on. Come on. Damn it, move! There we go. Come on, you two. Oh, we don't really need a light for that. It doesn't. Take a hike. You two. Oh, come on. Oh, I'm gonna push it out, don't I? That's why. Go on. There we go. Okay, again, we're creeping in case you haven't noticed. Jeez, look how dark that is. Let's not go that way then. How many? Oh, 14. That's okay, actually. Let's just clear out this level first, huh? When I say this level, I mean this kind of area first. So, just to make things a little bit easier for us. So we actually know what we've done and what we haven't done. Oh. Oh, this doesn't look like it's going to move at all. Oh, so we're on the other side of the wall. Okay. Kulina. Kitchen. I guess. To the kitchen. This is way too open. This is definitely a trap. Door closed. Okay. Note.
2nd of August, 1839. I have arrived at the village of Altstadt. It's a haven in the midst of a vast forest and the last stop before my final destination, Castle Brennenburg. It's late in the evening, and the outrider, who has been with the coach since Bremen, advised me to wait until morning before I venture further. I've arranged for a bed at Der Mühle, the village's only inn, and a man waiting for the sun to rise. I try to sleep, but as I close my eyes, I see the men who fell victim in London. My fear and shame forces me to witness the same scenes over and over. They are dead because of me.
Yeah. I shouldn't be happy about that, but I'm going to be happy about it anyway. Oh, nice. Thank you. Laudanum, thank you. Oh, jeez. Did that... Oh. Yeah, let's just use two. Do we still have our pot? No, we don't. Barrels filled with acid in the kitchen. Alright, well, we just got ourselves hurt by it. That's great. We're sneaking again. Crap. Now we're running. Nowhere really to hide. Crap. There is nowhere to hide. This is great. This is exactly what a game should be like. The only thing I can do is stand with my back facing them. Or crouch with my back facing the water. And just hope he doesn't beat the crap out of me. Then again, he doesn't do much damage, but if he does find me here, then he deserves to kill me. Because, yeah. Gone? Can I actually trust that he's gone and he's not in like the left or the right side? That's the thing. The music is still playing, which would suggest that he's still in the area. Jesus. I was not expecting that. How about this? Oh. Okay, music's back to normal again. Oh man, that was just so intense then. Even the stale bread, probably. Oh god. Okay. Ah, man. Ugh. Let's just go then. We don't know where the dude's gone though, that's the problem. Nothing quite like a freaky game. And that's back to the thing. I don't think he can chase us through there, in case you're wondering, so. Oh god, the only way he could have actually gone is this way when you think about it. Doesn't mean that he doesn't just respawn and disappear all the time though, so. It sounded like he's near here. Kitchen. Storage. No problem. I'll go to storage. Don't know what to do anyway, so what better thing to do? Storage again. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. Absolute shit.
Well, it's for his own good.
There's nothing here. Did that... That... My head is pounding and my hands are shaking. That's where he is. Oh man. Is he something like around here? Where is he now? Are we? We're back here again, aren't we? Cistern entrance. I can hear it. Can't tell where it is, but I can hear it.
Hey, you! Stop!
Don't come any closer! I just want to leave!
You can't go outside! It's too dangerous!
I'm telling Gabriel!
I doubt that very much.
Oh, God. Shit. And it's running for us as well, which is the worst possible outcome we could get. And my head is pounding and my hands are shaking. Oh, crap. Stuck in here then. Ugh. Damn it. Go away. Go on, keep going. Ugh, man. Oh, it actually looked like I could handle that. Somehow. We're in pitch darkness here, so I don't think he can see us, but don't really want to take that chance either. Oh crap. Which means he's around here somewhere. I don't know which way. Wait, I'm looking for a storage room, aren't I? Kitchen. So we're going the wrong way. Unless there's another sign nearby that says. Ah, there it is. Storage. Thank you. If he finds me here, I am dead. I have nowhere to hide. Man, I hate situations like this.
Third of August, 1839. I feel like I have fled the world and all its worries. Brandenburg is a majestic creation perched upon a forest-clad hill with towers reaching well above even the highest pine trees. Following the winding road leading to the gates gives the impression of discovering something forgotten, as if journeying with Marco Polo to the hidden Xanadu. Alexander, the Baron, is a peculiar but gracious man. He seems well-versed in worldly matters and is not at all as eccentric as I assumed. My room is exquisite, and I'm confident that no hotel for miles could even hope to match it. As the sun sets on Brandenburg, its fairy tale varnish turns to an eerie gloom. Alexander's strange servants are never far away. They are a quiet lot, and their behavior could only be described as skulking. Alexander seems pleased by my presence. As he puts it, it seems like I got here just in time.
Excuse me. Oh. Okay, that's the one with the padlock. Mm. hope this is a storage room. Yeah, that looks like storage to me. Oh, man. Oh, we're actually basically over time as well. Oh, I know what this is probably for, if you remember, but... Shh. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna finish this video here. And, yeah, thank you for watching as per usual, and next time we're going to, go back to the kitchen, try not to get freaked out again. Okay, see you guys then. Take care of yourselves out there, yeah?